About 6 months ago, I happened to come to Harrisburg and felt good and everything. And the fact I was here Monday and Tuesday, I started seeing double. So I called my doctor back home. He says, well, if you don't see double on the side, you're okay. He says, if you see double, then go see an ophthalmologist. So that night there, I went and had dinner and fell asleep. About 9:30, I woke up, and I had a little tingling there. So I called my daughter, who's a nurse. I said, Deb, I says, I have a little tingling. What do you think? She says, well, you better go to the doctor's. You might be having a stroke or something. Well, she scared the heck out of me, so I ended up and went to the emergency room. They had took Pinnacle. I got to give them a lot of credit because they did a fantastic job in the emergency room. So they were taking all kind of tests, and about 1:30, the doctor comes out and says, I want you to go directly to the hospital. I said, what do you mean? He says, well, you have a mast in here in the sinus cavity, and it's pushing up into your eyes. I said, do I have to go right now? He says, I want you to go directly to the hospital. So I had a good primary care physician at 1:30. He woke up and they called, made the arrangements for me. I go to the Hillman Cancer Center down there, and they took the biopsy, and here was lymphoma in the eye. And the doctor said, you got to get this treated. You can't do radiation because you lose your sight. He said, but the good news is that we can cure it. And hopefully, as of right now, that one, so far it's going good. But I had to have, I was in the hospital a week at a time, taking 24 hours of chemo for the whole week, for 6 weeks, and I was off 10 days. And my mother, years ago, passed away with ovarian cancer. And I have a lot of good friends. I think we all have friends out there who have passed away and who have got cancer, we all know that. But until you see the magnitude, when I was in the hospital, to see the magnitude of people, and that's not even the children. These are 18 years old and going on. You don't realize the enormous problem we have with cancer. It affects everybody. Oh, not only affects everybody, it really costs the healthcare system a tremendous amount of money. And we keep talking about it, and 45 years ago, they declared the war on cancer. And when I heard the moonshot that the president gave Joe Biden the hold, it made sense to me that we in Pennsylvania lead an effort to do this nationally to get everybody out there to cooperate. So that's the emphasis of the of why this is very important. Until you realize, you take good health for granted until you lose it. And then when you really see what's happening, then you get a different perspective. You can sympathize with somebody, and you say, well, you know, you're going, you know, go through that. But you don't realize it until you're really there and see all the people who are suffering. And believe me, thank God that I was able to maybe get it in time. But anyhow, I want to thank you all for joining in with us this morning for this vital, important topic. As I said, when President Obama announced the creation of the Cancer Moonshot Task Force, putting forth a concerted national effort to end cancer as we know it, I was struck by how big the task is, yet how successful our nation has been when faced with other equally large health challenges. I introduced House Resolution 695 to declare 2016 as the year to cure cancer in Pennsylvania. To not only call for a concerted effort in Pennsylvania to find these exclusive cures, but to shine light on the issues on the state level in all the states of our country. This has to be a coordinated effort nationally. Today, I urge all state legislators across the nation to also heed the call of reaching for the moon, in the fight to cure cancer and lend their support by passing similar resolutions. We have the ability and the expertise to find a cure if we all work together. When there was other health epidemics in this country, we rallied together and the public outcry persisted until we discovered a cause and either a cure or vaccine to prevent it. Polio is virtually gone from our nation's scene. Smallpox has been essentially eradicated. AIDS is no longer the widespread, almost always fatal disease it once was. It is now a chronic disease in which people can live longer and a full life. All of these advances came about because we were faced with enormous health challenges. So we joined forces, pulled together the best and the brightest, and supported their efforts towards finding solutions and saving lives. Cancer, ladies and gentlemen, is an enormous and complicated disease. Some forms of cancer touch virtually every family in our country in some way. And as I said, including my own family. If you was asked to describe cancer with just one word, I think that word would be humbling. From the minute you hear the diagnosis and get past the why me phase, when you sit in chemotherapy wards and look all around you, you realize the enormity of this disease. You realize you are not alone. There are so many people coming in for treatment that the numbers are staggering. What you also realize is that this cancer monster is rampant. And you can't help but think, with all the people touched by this, why haven't we can't conquered this disease yet? It's alarming to me that in 2016, we still have not identified more definite causes and cures for cancer. Most certainly, we have made incredible strides. There is groundbreaking research going on as we speak today. And I look forward to hearing some of these success stories from the esteemed experts that we have here today. But I can't help wonder, but what can we do? What will it take to eradicate this disease? And yes, ladies and gentlemen, it is an epidemic. Jonas Salk from Pittsburgh, with only his brain and a microscope, developed the vaccine to prevent polio. Smallpox has been 100% wiped out with vaccine worldwide. Modern scientists have discovered the causes of tetanus, rabies, yellow fever, measles, whooping cough, and others, which can also be prevented and stopped in their tracks with vaccine. Yet, cancer continues. Its destructiveness of your body, your mind, your personality, your family, and friends, and yes, your financial resources and your dignity. Somewhere along the line, ladies and gentlemen, our priorities have been stewed. People suffering and worry about how they are going to afford chemotherapy or pay their bills during the month. They cannot work because they have cancer, or worse yet, how their families will cope with it if they don't beat the disease. Yet, we pay professional athletes millions of dollars to play sports every year. Celebrities spend millions of dollars to live in the perfect house and millions of dollars for expensive engagement rings and jewelry. We have politicians spending a tremendous amount of money that could be used to find a cure for the future generations that would do something in this country beneficial instead of putting that money out in other respects. Now, Pennsylvania has a rich and deep research capacity. And as I stand here today, I'm proud that our institutions are leading the fight. We have world-renowned researchers from Pennsylvania right here on our stage today, and I want to thank you for coming. Thank you very much. However, cancer does not respect state borders. It crosses state lines and demographic lines. Cancer doesn't stop as you ask to ask directions. It doesn't discriminate. Cancer doesn't care if you live in Pennsylvania or any other state. Ladies and gentlemen, it is only through a cooperated, coordinated effort across state and national borders that we can end the scourge called cancer. Right here in all corners of Pennsylvania, we have the resources, we have the researchers, and the shiny stars working diligently to lead the nation and show other states how successful we can be, how we can find a cure, help find a cure by joining forces. Pennsylvania is clearly leading the way. But there must be a national, state, and even local support of research and treatment efforts if we are ever going to win this battle. Today, I ask all states to make a real concerted effort to support collaboration efforts, to back information sharing, to promote an all-out national effort to find a cure sooner rather than later. I asked all entities across the country actively join in this national effort to shoot for the moon. I asked all state legislators across the country to lend their support by resolution similar to House Bill 695. Ladies and gentlemen, as I said before, it's been 45 years since President Nixon signed the National Cancer Act and launched the war on cancer. Our children, our families, can't wait another 45 years to come up with something, a cure.